apartment building. One of the center apartments is a small personal care home, three persons. You may recall that personal care homes with only two or three people do not require initial use approval. It's operated for a while. What they're proposing is to expand into the adjacent apartment and combine the two apartments together into one larger dwelling unit. And then expand from three persons up to four. And as that increase of one more person puts them over the threshold for initial uses requirement. And in this case, they're actually lessening the impacts, going from four-unit apartment buildings down to two apartments with one larger personal care home. Very good area for multifamily development, and certainly uses of this nature may have operated for many years without hardly even being noticed. And so adding one more person and reducing the number of tenants next door is certainly a positive move. There's one interesting thing to note in your packet on the two-letter page of opposition from the neighbor who owns the vacant lot to the east, Mr. Ward. He used to own the subject property as well. He's going to build the apartment building, and he has raised an issue about the water line that serves his building. It cuts across the rear of his lot to Devine Street. If you look at the arrow, you can see what the streets are. That is the closest route from this building to the water lines of public streets, which is why they were put in that way. He has requested the current owner of this property to relocate that line, and they haven't yet, so he's raising that issue. He had told us that he was coming to the planning commission meeting. In addition to submitting a letter, he did not show up at the planning commission meeting. I do not know if he's going to come to your meeting Thursday night.
I have a question about that. Now, he owned both those pieces.
Both of those. He's the one who subdivided it.
That ran the utilities across that vacant lot.
Correct.
To his house, right?
Correct. Well, to the street. The vacant lot, you know, it's something that he created. He built the building, he laid the water lines, which is why he knows where they're located. He ran into some financial difficulties, lost the apartment building to the bank, and later got foreclosed and repurchased. And so there's a little bit of history there. And several of these lots were all in one family ownership once upon a time, and there are several places where water service lines cut across properties. There's no development issue there unless you want to put a building on top of one. But in this case, it's the existing building. There's no proposed changes to the building, so nothing triggers that. It's simply a matter of identifying where the line is running. It's not a land use type of issue, but it's certainly an issue between the property. So he may show up first time.
Is that lot big enough to build on?
It barely. What's interesting, he thinks the water line, which you envision the south face of the apartment building and go due east over to Devine Street, that's where the water line runs. He thinks that's in the way of any future building. But that's a very narrow part of the lot. I don't think it's at all feasible that any building he would build would be on that part of the lot. I think any building that could possibly fit would have to be in the wider part, which is to the south and away from that water line. But you know, it's a pretty narrow lot there.
So the lot is what you're talking about to the right of the apartment?
To the right, actually the corner of the lot.
And who owns that?
David Ward is his name.
And he's the one who adjusts?
He's the one who submitted that letter to. He is the former owner of the Southern property and the one who built the building.
You get that beautiful, that house.